For the third time this season, the Seahawks will battle it out with the Los Angeles Rams, this time for the opportunity to go deeper into the playoffs. What's going on, Jackie Montgomery, with your wild card playoff preview? Well, the Seahawks and Rams split the regular season series, with the Seahawks winning the most recent matchup just 2 weeks ago. Given the short turnaround with a Saturday game, offensive coordinator Brian Schottenheimer sees a lot of benefit to playing a familiar opponent.
On a short week like this, you know, the Saturday kickoff is actually a good thing. Because you know them, right? You know them, you know the way they play, you know the style, you know the people. Imagine if you're playing a little bit of a different opponent on a short week, maybe that you're not as familiar with, you're in a little bit more of a scramble mode. I mean, we know the faces. We know, okay, Aaron's going to be there, and then there's Brockers, and there's Leonard, and then there's the linebackers. Okay, Jalen's going here, he's going there. I think it's a benefit because we do understand each other, and we literally just played whatever it was 10 days ago. It's a benefit. They're still great, but it's a benefit because at least we know them and we're familiar with their personnel and a little bit of their scheme.
In the Week 16 meeting, quarterback Jared Goff fractured his thumb, requiring surgery. He missed LA's Week 17 outing and is listed as questionable for Saturday. If the five-year pro doesn't play, John Wolford will play in just his second NFL game ever. Last week with the start, Wolford completed 22 of his 38 passes for 231 yards, zero touchdowns, and an interception.
The biggest thing was, him being a little bit more mobile. Definitely felt like he, when he didn't have it downfield, he took off and ran the ball. Goff did it, a little bit in our game, but not the way he did it in Arizona. So I wouldn't be surprised if they even threw in a couple design quarterback runs for him. So I think that would be the big difference. As far as the offense, it was still the same offense, still making the same reads. Still looking for the same guys. Obviously, you want to get the ball in your playmakers' hands, and he'll have more playmakers this week, but I definitely expect him to use his legs a little bit when he has to.
There's just a couple plays in there that are different, Jackie. He took off and ran a couple times, and it was a little bit of a different dimension for them. And they had a couple plays in the offense that allowed him to run the football. And so there's an opening there to how they think he can fit in and help them. So we'll see what happens. We don't know who's going to play. We're preparing for both quarterbacks, but we are aware that John has run the football a little bit, and coach has seen that in him, and so we may see more of that.
The Rams offense has not scored a touchdown in two straight games, including the last meeting against the Seahawks. LA announced Wednesday that leading receiver Cooper Kupp has been activated from the COVID-19 list and will be available Saturday. The team's leading rusher, rookie Cam Akers, returned last week after missing the Seahawks game with an injury.
It's pretty good. He's explosive. He can put his foot down and make an explosive run at any point. We have to do a great job with our fits. He's a guy that can get to the outside. He also has a good inside running game, and he outruns people. So, again, he's a guy that he makes their offense go.
There's no question the Rams' defense is the strength of this team. It ranks number one in the NFL in total defense, pass defense, and scoring, allowing a league-low 18.5 points per game.
They do everything well. They got a great defensive line. They got really good linebackers that can run side to side. The DBs can really play. They do a great job. They're coached extremely well. It's going to be a great matchup, we have a lot of respect for how they play the game and how they go about their business.
In their defensive front seven, five-time All-Pro defensive tackle Aaron Donald gets much of the attention, and rightfully so. He sacked Russell Wilson more than any other quarterback he's faced. This year, he's only sacked Wilson once, but the attention he requires has opened up other players on the Rams' defense, like linebacker Leonard Floyd, who is responsible for 5 of the Rams' 11 sacks on Wilson this year.
He's been a really, really big addition for them, and they've always had really good edge rushers. Before it was, Robert Quinn and had Dante Fowler, and now his addition, he just brings a lot of speed off the edge. He's a very talented pass rusher, really good athlete, plays hard, and he helps them out in everything they like to do as far as, just one-on-one rushes or line blitzes and games. Really good, really talented football player, and he's had a really good year. So somebody we definitely have to focus in on and control in order to have success.
To close out the regular season, the Seahawks faced three straight top five NFL defenses. While it may have taken time for the offense to get fully going in some of those contests, Ryan Schottenheimer and Russell Wilson were able to make the adjustments necessary to find the end zone and win the games.
Obviously, you know, you always want to start faster. Obviously, we know how to start fast. We've done that a lot this year. But I think that we also, the key is also being able to finish. And I think the good thing about some of these past couple weeks' games, in my opinion, is that to be able to be in tight matchups, tight games at the end of the, you know, end of the season to help prepare you for the playoffs, because playoff matchups are always kind of crazy. They can be emotional. They can be all this and that. And the team that can really settle down and be calm and be poised and be focused in on what the mission is and execute at the end of the game, those are the teams that usually win.
The offensive line is expected to be at full strength this weekend with starting left guard Mike Iupati and right tackle Brandon Shell available.
It's a great feeling. It's a great feeling. We had a lot of injuries, you know, a lot of shuffling along the line throughout the year. And so, to have our most important game of the season to be at full strength, it's a great feeling to have all the depth that we need going into this game against a very, very tough defense. Very tough defensive front. It means everything for us.
The Seahawks defense is looking to continue their massive turnaround since midseason. In the last meeting with the Rams, they kept them out of the end zone, allowing just 9 points on the day. Seattle is also hopeful that Jamal Adams will be available to play this weekend after leaving the last game with a shoulder injury.
I'm okay. I'm looking forward to it. I'm not going to be limited to anything. I'm full go. I'm full energy. I'm me. I'm going out there to, continue to make plays and continue to help the team win. That's what I'm about.
Well, the Seahawks are 6-0 when playing at home under Pete Carroll in the playoffs. They're hoping to continue that here on Saturday. Kickoff is set for 1:40 p.m. Pacific, and you can watch it live on Q13 Fox.